Hello guys, Dhananjay and welcome back to a new video. Asus G14 is back and this is the 2021 edition. I have the 5900HS variant with RTX 3060, which is a monster. The pricing for this variant should be around 1,50,000 rupees, and for the specifications that it offers and for the performance that it offers, I feel like that's a great pricing, and it may get a little bit lower as well in the future, but right now it shows pricing as 1,55,000 rupees on Amazon India. Let's start with the display panel, because this is a gaming laptop and the display panel obviously has to be a high refresh rate. So this is a 120Hz 1440p display panel with great viewing angles, amazing color accuracy. Or is it? This is a gaming laptop, so colors do look a little bit extra saturated in my opinion. So that's why we used this laptop with an external monitor. We were using a Gigabyte 1440p monitor, which also has 144Hz refresh rate, and monitor was always running at 144Hz refresh rate, and it has better colors and all that stuff. I'm not saying the display on this laptop is bad, it's just that when you edit videos and you are doing that minor color correction, having a little bit of extra saturated display matters when you're color correcting. But when it comes to gaming, this is a fantastic display, no issues whatsoever. The 120Hz refresh rate display works really good. If you play esport titles such as CSGO or Valorant, the display looks fantastic. The only downside that you may feel about the display is that it is a 14-inch display. But obviously you're looking at this laptop because you probably want a display panel of 14 inches only. Next up, we are going to talk about the performance itself, and I'm going to talk about editing first, because 5900HS is like, I was actually surprised. It gives desktop like performance with this particular laptop. Obviously RTX 3060 is there, which contributes to it, but 5900HS did not disappoint me. Benchmarks like Cinebench and all are like too easy for this particular laptop, and when it comes to editing, we used this particular laptop to do our primary editing and we had literally zero complaints. Premiere Pro was very smooth. Forget Premiere Pro, we used After Effects for a few videos. I'll show you timeline and everything, a roll of that particular thing, and the laptop was able to handle everything without any issue. After Effect timeline, not just with one or two videos, but with multiple videos, with multiple effects, multiple text effects, and still the laptop was able to play it back very smoothly. And I'm comparing the performance with a PC with 3700X and RTX 2060 Super or RTX 3070 or even the 6700 XT. Even then, the laptop performance was really good. Obviously, in those scenarios, processor is the most important, and 3700X and 5900HS, I feel like, are so close. And in some cases, 59, no, it's not, I won't really say it, call it better, but the performance was so good that it can easily replace our PC and we can use this as our primary editing machine. So if you are an editor looking for amazing performance in a small form factor, this is definitely the laptop to go for. If gaming is your priority, still I will say the same, that this is an amazing gaming laptop as well. The 3060 present in this one means that it is an ray tracing enabled card, RTX card obviously, so Cyberpunk 2077 or Battlefield 5 are going to look amazing. And the FPS performance was pretty good as well, no complaints over here. We ran few more gaming benchmarks and here are the results of them. Now, when it comes to gaming, this is a RTX 3060 powered laptop, but this is a 65W TDP laptop. Now, the laptop weighs at just 1.7 kgs. It feels really nice. It's very small, very compact. It can fit into literally any bag that you have, like the backpack. And that's one of the reasons why the 3060 is limited to 65W. Am I going to complain about that? Not really. My primary aim for this machine was editing, and in that case, processor is the most important. 5900HS was killing it. 3060, 65W TDP against a 3060 with, let's say, 80 or 100W TDP. It's not going to be the same, but the performance, gaming performance on this particular laptop with this particular form factor and the heating, which was not really there, I am going to give it 9.5 out of 10 from my side. Literally, when it comes to performance, you can get this laptop with these specifications, which I tested, without worrying about performance or frame drops or Premiere Pro lagging or something like that. A lot of times I hear people saying, buy the MacBook M1 because it comes with M1 and all. Have you used MacBook M1 with multiple layers of videos, like 3, 4, 4K 60fps videos, multiple text layers, and then try playing it back? Will it run? Try running After Effects on that MacBook M1, MacBook Air M1, or even the Macs with M1. M1 chipset is good and all for a Final Cut Pro and all that stuff, but for heavy workflow when it comes to After Effects or Premiere Pro with multiple videos, multiple timelines, it is going to struggle where this laptop does not. And this one costs just 1,50,000 rupees. Just because when you compare the MacBook M1 or M1 Pro or anything, then this one shines when it comes to editing department, in my personal opinion. The laptop comes with 1 TB SSD, and that's a crazy fast SSD, crazy fast. It can, in some operations, it can go up to 1.2 to 1.4 Gbps of speed, which is one of the fastest, and that is one of the reasons why editing experience or gaming experience has been so good, because all the games were present on that SSD, and editing footage, editing software, everything is present on that SSD, which is so fast. There is no bottleneck from the SSD side, no matter what you try to do on the laptop. Now let's talk about some of the other things, such as the keyboard. The keyboard has nice tactile feedback. It does have little bit of depth, but the keys are limited. There is no numpad, obviously, due to the size, it had to be there. But since the keys are so tactile, using the keyboard on the laptop was a pleasant experience. The trackpad on this laptop is small, once again, due to the size. When you buy a G14 with a 14-inch size, any laptop for that matter is going to have a similar type of setup, but the trackpad is fantastic, feels great to touch, and having using gestures and everything, no complaints with the trackpad as well as keyboard. The only complaint is that it doesn't have numpad, and I'm used to numpad, but I can't complain because of the size. Once again, the speakers on this laptop are good enough. They do become sufficiently loud, could have been louder in my opinion. So if you're planning to watch a YouTube video alone in your room and there is not a lot of noise, these speakers are more than enough. But if you're planning to watch an entire movie by keeping the laptop a little bit far away from you, then these speakers may not be loud enough for you. But the speaker quality overall is pretty good.
Just my assumption, I am not really sure about the pricing. I'm assuming it will be 14,000 rupees. That's a great...
As I said, single person watching the YouTube video from this much distance is totally fine, and it does become sufficiently loud. One noticeable thing is that the speaker quality is very good, and that's something which I feel is personally very important for me. The speaker quality should be good, that's there. It's just that could happen a little bit louder, but again, size. The laptop does have a fingerprint sensor inside the power button. Last generation G14 had issues with fingerprint sensor. This generation fixes a lot of it. Fingerprint sensor recognition is much better this time. Now, next up, we are going to talk about the display quality and the animatrics basically that you can have on the G14. And build quality wise, it's really good. I can hold it in one hand very comfortably, just 1.7 kgs. Considering the specifications that it has to offer, it is not too thick, and that has been one of the points because of which I love G14, using G14, because it does not take a lot of space, it does not make a lot of noise. Asus also claims to have fans which eliminate dust from them inside. What? Can such technology exist? You may think like this, but it actually works, because and this is another proof that we actually use the laptop for editing. We used it so much that we have few lines below the display panel where you can see the dust forming up from the fans, because fans take air from this side and then exhaust it from over here, and then the dust lines are formed because the fan actually exhausts dust, and that can be seen working, like right now working. I will have to clean it. If you plan to buy the G14, remember to clean it. 76 watt hour battery is present. Streaming IPL for, let's say, about 4 hours was possible, and the battery went from 100% to 0%, and we were not using it at best performance to stream IPL. But if you plan to edit a video, like heavy 4K 60fps videos, then you may get about 1 hour and 30 minutes of editing time, even gaming time, because gaming laptops are not supposed to be used on battery, they are supposed to be used while charging. Next up, let's talk about heating, because that's also important. And as I said earlier, the laptop has RTX 3060, which can go up to 65 watts only, which is not a lot, it's not 100 watts. So that's why the heating is much limited. And if I compare it to another laptop that we use daily, that's Tough A15. That Tough A15 can go to 99 degrees, 100 degrees very easily. This one goes to about 90, 95 degrees while editing or while gaming as well, which is much better. And it does not, the keys WASD keys do not become too warm. Normal basic warm is totally fine in gaming laptops. There is no overheating that I noticed on the G14. And I guess that's pretty much it for this particular video. There are plenty of ports. USB Type-C port is present, but that's not a Thunderbolt port. That's okay. This is an AMD laptop, Intel. It's not an Intel laptop. There are two USB Type-C ports, two USB A ports, one full-size HDMI A port and a headphone jack, and a 170 watt charging brick is also included inside the box itself. You can also charge the laptop with the USB Type-C port which is provided over here. And I guess that's pretty much it for this particular video. I was extremely happy with the G14's performance, and G4 overall the laptop is fantastic. Gets 9.5 out of 10 from my side. The last generation G14 was one of my favorites. This G14 is no exception to that. Huge thumbs up from my side. If you're looking for amazing performance in a small form factor, this is the laptop to go for. If you enjoyed this video, give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. If you still have any more doubts, suggestions or queries regarding the laptop, do let me know about that in the comment section box below. I'll try to answer those queries. So yeah, thank you guys. Thank you for watching.